more shorter and quicker. That's just it. And it's like,
oh, is this better?
That's better.
Okay.
No, that's for here. I was gonna say, I was using like tapping with my leg. And again, I feel a little bit here that, you know, your insides are firing. If you go forward, yeah, you gotta stay over your leg. Because I seriously, at this point, she's sensitive. You know, I would check this back and let it go. Check the back, let it go. Check the back, let it go. Check the back, let it go. You know? And then it's like, you're just going to keep that better. You got to keep nothing.
Because then she does this thing where it like feels like she's like, mate, help me. Do it.
No, I mean, to me, that's probably you abandoning her. You know? And it's like, yeah, but again, this is like not bad. Like, if she swapped on me, you could get some lunch out of it. I'm not saying this to the neck. I'm also saying behind the feet of the saddle. Like, guard with that outside leg.
Okay.
Yeah, make sure you're half halting with both reins, checking it back. That you're not, again, that it's like when you let go at this point, I think normally I let go at the beginning, but still support on the outside, but I'm kind of going. You know, I need to make sure that, yeah, you are not holding on that outside. You know, I just probably some of that stuff still
mean
about the, you know, the crookedness. Because like I said, she did that one time with me on whatever day that was, Tuesday one.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, that's what you're gonna have to be doing is just, you know, a ton of that until,
okay,
you know, until stuff gels.
Mm-hmm. And that's the canter, everything's coming out.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
I mean, I would even mind, I think probably, I mean, like I said, I didn't come up with the changes too.
Right.
I did a couple just changing range, but
yeah,
you know, those have been going fairly well. I feel like the biggest thing for you is the preparation of the pounds.
Yeah.
So I don't want to put that on a little bit of my time.
Yeah. This is another block of core.
It's a bit too slow.
Because then I can put it faster and it feels fun.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm doing. Yeah, exhibit A. You gotta see, this is the thing. I would be able to take that canter and quicken that up without changing the stride length. So that's the part, you know, that yeah, I think that you're really missing. Is that you can't, it's like you can't change the tempo irrespective of the stride length.
And that, because when she does that, it doesn't get all in her hands. So what am I
doing? Oh, yeah, because you can. My canter without that.
Okay.
Yeah, all of that.
Okay.
And, you know, quicken it up without my waist. Use your leg here. This is the part where I feel like, I mean, for lack of a better phrase, I'm meaner with my leg. I think I touched her with the whip like 3 times, but it was mainly when she was failing on me and she got off. It was like, otherwise, I'm giving her, you know, short little tasks, and I didn't even have brows on. I had my little boring, you know, stubby spurs on. So it's like, you know, to me, I just go, if I touch with my leg, I need some sort of response. I cannot stand it, and I feel like I'm going to work with it back. That was a bit better.
Yeah, because you pulled on my hand, and then I said, no, that's my leg.
Yeah. You know, and this is just, I have a feeling this is just going to be a practice to clean up the changes and
yes.
But it's like, yeah. But I just keep checking it back, and I'm kind of going like, no, we're not, you know, don't switch the subject. It's like, stay here and, you know, get